This place is so remote and so hard to get a permit for that only 1,200 people come here every year. And that's compared to Kakadu, which is just south of here, that gets over 200,000. I'm on my way to join a group that offers a true wilderness camping experience in what I think is probably one of the best parts of Australia. Garrig National Park is on the Coburg Peninsula at the western tip of Arnhem Land, about 200 k's northeast of Darwin. I arrived early on day three of an eight-day tour through Kakadu and Arnhem Land, run by World Expeditions. They'd set up camp at a great spot called Observation Cliffs at the northern tip of the peninsula. World Expeditions is the only tour group allowed into this area.
We're going to be heading off in about 45 minutes.
Guide Chris Bikes rallied the troops for a day away from camp.
You don't have to be a hardcore camper to enjoy this trip. Everything's supplied, your camping gear, all the food, but you do have to pitch in and give a hand. But if you're clever or your timing's good, you can always get out of it.
Our small group headed across the bay to Victoria Settlement at Port Essington. The only way to get to this place is by boat. It takes about 55 minutes. The tour usually spends a few hours on a 2.5 kilometre circuit around this fascinating historic site. In 1838, the British tried to establish a defence and trading post in these desolate northern parts, but they weren't quite prepared for its harsh environment.
We're here in the dry season, it's 30 odd degrees, it's hot. But you can just imagine when the soldiers came here to settle Victoria, they were in their full woolen uniforms. They basically had no idea what they were in for.
The design is Cornish, designed for cool, windy, wet climate. But here we're in tropical Coburg, completely the opposite.
Despite contact with local Aborigines, the settlers refused to learn traditional food gathering techniques, and the harsh environment finally beat them. The waters surrounding the peninsula form the Northern Territory's largest marine park, but the underwater environment here is just as inhospitable as the conditions on land.
This water looks so tempting, and you can go swimming, but there's always a chance you might get taken by a croc or a shark. Then you've got to worry about box jellyfish, sea snakes. Don't forget about stonefish, also the blue-ringed octopus. Actually, even when it's really hot, I think you'd have to be pretty stupid to go swimming in there.
Yep, there you go, black-tipped reef shark. Got that tail, little black tip.
And so what have you thought of the tour so far?
Brilliant, really fabulous. You get a lot of information about what we see, the bush and the Aboriginal heritage here and things like that, but it's also very relaxing.
The remoteness, the wilderness, the wild, if you come from an urban environment, it's fantastic. I mean, I shouldn't say too much because it's a secret one ought to really keep.
Well, these guys have got another 2 days here and then they go down to Kakadu for a couple of days. You're not going to find a place like this anywhere else in the world. It is true wilderness and this is a great way to see it. But be prepared, it's hot, there are a lot of creepy crawlies and you can't go swimming. But if you're given the chance to get up here, jump in.
The Coburg and Kakadu adventure is run by World Expeditions. The eight-day trip costs $1,490, including transfers from Darwin, all meals and accommodation. Tours run in the dry season, from May to October.
Feel like a holiday? A nice cheap